Prostate cancer doesn't care if you're famous. Even former President Joe Biden faced it. On May 16th, 2025, he got the news after noticing some urinary issues that wouldn't go away. His Gleason score? A 9, which puts him in the red light zone. Aggressive stuff. Tests showed it spread to his bones, making it tougher to cure. But here's the hopeful part. His cancer responds to hormone therapy, drugs that can keep it in check for years. Back in 2014, his last PSA check was normal, and since he was over 65, routine tests weren't pushed. Older guys sometimes skipped them to avoid overtreating small problems. Now, his late-stage diagnosis has people wondering if earlier checks could have caught it sooner. Either way, Biden's handling it with treatment and a lot of support, showing that even a tough score doesn't mean game over. Picture this. You're at the doctor's office and they mention a Gleason score. It sounds technical, but it's really just a number that helps figure out how serious prostate cancer is. Whether you're a guy facing this diagnosis, supporting a loved one, or just curious, knowing what the Gleason score means can take some of the mystery out of prostate cancer. We'll walk through it step by step, how it works, what the numbers mean, and how it helps to decide on a treatment plan. By the end, you'll feel more in the know and ready to talk about it with your doctor. The Gleason score is like a report card for prostate cancer. It shows how aggressive the cancer might be, basically how fast it could grow or spread. Doctors figure out by looking at cancer cells under a microscope and comparing them to healthy prostate cells. The score runs from 6 to 10. A higher score means the cancer is more aggressive. Doctors take a small sample of your prostate, called a biopsy. It's just a quick pinch of tissue. Then, a specialist checks out the cells and looks for the two most common patterns of how they're growing. Each pattern gets a grade from 1 to 5. Grade 1, the cells look pretty normal and slow moving. Grade 5, the cells look very strange and fast growing. They add the two grades together to get your Gleason score. For example, 2 grade 3 patterns equals 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. A grade 4 and a grade 3 equals 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. You won't see scores below 6 because those usually mean it's not cancer. Let's make this easy with a traffic light idea. Each Gleason score gives you a signal about what to expect. Green light, Gleason 6, 3 plus 3. The cancer is chilled out, slow growing, and not likely to cause trouble soon. Many patients live with this for years without it being a big deal. Yellow light, Gleason 7, 3 plus 4 or 4 plus 3. This is the middle zone. 3 plus 4, mostly grade 3 cells, so it's less aggressive. 4 plus 3, more grade 4 cells, so it's a bit feistier. It might need some action, but the outlook is often good with treatment. Red light, Gleason 8 to 10, like 4 plus 4, 4 plus 5, or 5 plus 5. The cancer's in high gear, aggressive and more likely to spread. It's a bigger challenge, but treatment can still make a difference. The Gleason score isn't the whole story, but it's a huge piece of the puzzle when deciding what to do about prostate cancer. Doctors also look at PSA levels, a blood test that can hint at how active the cancer is. Cancer stage, whether it's still in the prostate or has spread. PSMA PET imaging is a special scan where doctors inject a tiny amount of safe radioactive tracer that sticks to PSMA on cancer cells. The tracer lights up on the scan, showing exactly where the cancer is. Even tiny spots that other tests might miss, like in bones or lymph nodes. It's super accurate for finding if cancer has spread, metastasized, which helps doctors plan the best treatment. Your health. Things like your age and energy level. Here's how the score might steer your options. Gleason 6, often it's watch and wait, called active surveillance. You'd get regular checkups to keep tabs on it. No rush to jump into big treatments. Gleason 7, this could go a few ways. 4 3 plus 4, maybe surgery or radiation. 4 4 plus 3, they might push a little harder since it's riskier. It depends on you and the cancer's vibe. Gleason 8 to 10, time to bring out the big guns. Maybe surgery plus radiation or drugs to slow it down. The goal is to tackle it head on. The Gleason score is like a heads up about what the cancer's up to. 6, no need to panic, it's slow. 7, pay attention, but there's hope. 8 to 10, act fast and you still got options. It's not foolproof. Sometimes a biopsy misses a spot, but it's a solid clue to start with. The Gleason score might sound intimidating, but it's really just a tool to help you and your doctor make smart moves. Whether it's keeping an eye on a low score or fighting a high one, understand it puts you in the driver's seat. Next time you're at the doctor, try asking, "What's my Gleason score and what's it telling us?" You might be surprised how much clearer things get. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to leave them below. If you found this video helpful, we'd appreciate it if you could like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.